unboxing video. My box came so freaking late. It's like the end of the month. I can't think of what the day is. I don't know. It's a little late. I know. I'm sorry. You probably have seen everybody's March's BoxyCharm, but here I am.
Yeah, yeah.
So this is March's BoxyCharm. I'm super, super excited. I did peek in there because I can't wait. I just can't wait. I got it today in the mail. I could not wait. I'm sorry. but I did not look a lot into it. So let's just get started with the video, okay? Really quickly, before we get started, if you did not know, I do upload every Wednesday and Saturday. Things are going a little hectic, so I feel like I shouldn't say that right now. I don't know if I should move to one day a week until school ends, like until the semester ends. I don't know yet, but thanks to the MVPs that are sticking with me. And if you have not subscribed, hit that button down below so you can see this weirdo some mo. Hit the little bell notification so you can be up, you can be notified. You can be notified every time I upload. Let's just get into the video, okay? Because I don't want to talk for 5 million trillion years, which I already have, so. Here's the box. I'm super excited with these little things coming out. So, let's just peek on in there. So, here it is. The card for this month is Creepy Cute. I like the colors, but this is just like a little ipsy-ish, I feel like. I don't know. I like the colors though. So let's see what is in here. The first thing I'm gonna pick out is this bad boy right here. Super excited. I've never used this one before. And I am going to try out the products on like I do most BoxyCharm videos. But I've never used this one. It's the Photo Finish Foundation Primer. It's like the OG one, I think. Never tried this one. I love the pore minimizing one. I'm gonna focus it on my T-zone. Whoa. Is that supposed to happen? I don't think that's supposed to happen. I don't think so. Looks like it snotted some boogers at me. And what the heck? Maybe I should shake it up. Because isn't it like a silicone kind of primer? I hope. Whoa, it's not a silicone primer. I swore I thought this one was like a pore filling primer this whole time. It's like this gel like primer. Whoa. Yeah, that's most definitely not gonna help for oily skin. Nothing special. So this primer is the Photo Finish Primer. It is $16. Yeah, I like it. Definitely did not see it as that kind of texture. I've never used it before, so I'm a little surprised it was like gel, not gel like, but like I don't know, like moisturizer or something. I don't know, very weird. Let's move on. I'm going to put on my foundation and I'm going to put it on with this bad boy. This did not come in the box, but I've been wanting to use this. I got it at Target like over a week ago and I have not used it. And it's super, super cool looking. It's by Eco Tools. I believe where I saw this was from Tati on her channel. And it comes with a smaller one also. And it was like $8.99 at Target. So I'm super excited because it has this little slant kind of curve. I don't know. That's really, I don't know. Excited. She loved it. So if Tati loves it, I mean, like, come on. I like this sponge, dude. All right, so I did face, bronzer, blush, brows, yeah, and concealer. Yeah, I don't think that primer did anything different for my skin. My skin looks the same. If anything, it hydrated my skin a little bit, which is good because around my eyebrows, they always just don't look good with foundation on top. Just in this area, I don't know why, it's just dry all the time. But we're gonna move on to the next thing. By the way, this is bomb. It has that slant so you can get right underneath there. It's just, yes, yes. Next thing is this bad boy right here in the little bubble wrap. Let's see what it is. Okay, I'm excited. It says Naked Cosmetics. These are pretty colors, dude. Wowza, wowza. They have colors I wouldn't... They have colors I wouldn't really use. Wow. Oh, and this thing doesn't bend all the way back, so it's kind of awkward. There's like a nice olivey green color, a really orange color, and this nice purple plum kind of color. I feel like out of all of these, I would use this one the most. It's very pretty. I'm super excited. Super, super excited. I'm going to swatch the purple. Ooh. That's pretty. It's not as metallic-y as I thought it was gonna be. Let's see the orange. Ooh, that one's pretty. I don't like really a lot of like really warm shades on my brows on my eyes though. Ooh, and it has like a green with a gold flecks in it. I'm going to use the purple one today. It is $39.99, the Urban Rustic palette. And it doesn't say that anywhere on the palette other than on this thing, so not sure why not. I'm going to use like a matte brown from another palette and I'll be right back. So now I'm gonna go in with that purple plum kind of color. And I'm just gonna take out my ring finger because that's normally how I apply my lid colors. So this is pretty bold for me. I don't know how I feel about it. I went a little too smoky under, and that's not my taste. Oh snap. Oh snap. It's pretty. It really does make your brown eyes pop if you have brown eyes. I feel like, whoa, I look very, very... I don't wear a lot of dark eyeshadow. but I'm just going to curl my lashes, put some mascara on, see how it... Maybe it looks a little bit after mascara. So that is how it is with mascara. I think it looks a little bit better. I don't know. I think it's very bold for me, which is probably not bold at all for some people. But I like purple. I like it with the brown eye contrast. And the black mascara really makes it pop. So it's kind of growing on me. But when I look in the viewfinder, it's very, very, very dark. But in person, it doesn't look super, super dark, dramatic. Let's just move on. Next thing I'm going to pick out is this bad boy right here. Let's see what this is. It's Real Her. I don't know if that's the brand. It's called Expert Advice Lip Liner, and it is an I Am Loved. It looks very pretty. Very pretty dark, like burgundy color, which won't go with the eye look, I don't think. But we're gonna put it on. We're gonna rock it. Super excited. Let's see how much this one was. $12.50. I feel like that's not that bad. Let's see how it works though. I wouldn't pay $12.50, but ooh, this looks pretty. It looks like I lost the cap, and so I just took another cap from like a NYX lip liner and put it on top of this, but yeah. It looks kind of patchy. It's very, very, very dark. I don't outline my lips. I don't lip line unless if I do, it's, you know, like a very natural color. So when it comes to dark colors, like I totally kind of like went a little, I feel like I look a little crazy. On to the next thing, which is right here. This is, it's Twin Sister. It's Sister. It is by the same brand, and it's in I Am a Rockstar. It's not the same shade as this one. This one's called I Am Loved. So hopefully these match somewhat, because I'm going to put this on top. I mean, going for it, right? It is a liquid lipstick. Ooh, I like the packaging. This is real cute. Okay, So we are going to try it on top of this. Hopefully it works out. We'll see. Ooh, smells like citrus. It looks a little like jagged over here. I don't know why I didn't apply it like that. It could have been so did that when it was first wet. I don't know. I'm not good with liquid lips or anything like that. Yeah, it's very dark. It exaggerates those dry little flakes if you have dry lips. Exfoliate first because this will show it real quick. It's very, very dark. Woo! That retails for $15. That's not bad at all for a liquid lipstick. I don't know. These are the kinds that I don't really typically like. Why couldn't I say that? They feel like, I don't know, it feels like it's gonna start crusting and peel after a while. I don't know. But the price of the liquid lipstick was $15, which is crazy because the lip liner was $12.50. They're almost the same price. But yeah. One more thing in the box. It's a sad day when there's only one thing left in the box. but it looks like a makeup brush. It is a Jumbo Kabuki fan brush by the Crown Brush brand. I've always wanted to try this brand because it's more of a affordable brush line. They even have makeup. They have like eyeshadow, I believe. And I've always wanted to try them. Don't know why I smelled it, but it is a fan brush. I'm super excited to try this out. Ooh, that's a little big for a fan brush, but we're gonna try it out. Go ahead and try it out with the Flower Beauty highlighting palette. I love this thing. It's so freaking gorgeous. If you don't have it, like, you need it. $13, yes. Anyways, I'm gonna use my favorite shade, which is like that champagne kind of color. And, oh, I feel like this is very dense for a highlighting brush too. I don't know. The fan brush I have is very small. There it goes. Let's see. Whoop. Oh, that's a big stripe mark. Brush is $18.99. Hot damn! I swore I thought Crown Brush was more inexpensive, like $6 to $10 range. Damn, that's expensive. Like, that is everything I got in my box this month. I feel super ready for the fall. Even though the first day of spring was like what, 2 days ago or a couple of days ago. Look like I'm ready to go to a Nirvana concert with this lipstick and eyeshadow. Anyways, that is everything I got in my box this month. I will put how much the price of the total box is right here because I've not done the math, but I'm sure it's expensive. I don't know if it reached $100. If it did, it barely reached it. Anyways, hopefully you guys liked this video. If you haven't already, please hit that button down below so you can see this weirdo some more. If you like this video, please give it a big old thumbs up and hit that little notification bell looking button so you can be notified when I upload. And yeah, I will see you guys next time. Bye.